Yes, I like.
Specialist trainer.
What's wrong, you two?
I am asking Specialist Trainer about why she found my voice sexually attractive.
Oh, really? Oh, shut up. I hadn't even met you yet.
This is a really good cheese, Shepard. I put some in through the filters. Is it organic?
On one occasion, you said that you wanted to, quote, pin my voice against the wall and run your tongue along its collarbone.
Well, there's a context there that... You were talking about quantum entanglement, and I didn't know you were an AI. There's some kind of herb in the cheese that I can't quite place. Is it sage or basil?
Anyway, I was just joking. You know, stress of the retrofits and...
Really? My diagnostic suggested that you were genuinely aroused.
It's really rare to get herbed dextro cheeses. The Turians almost never bother.
You have diagnostics. Cerberus programmed you to check body language.
I get more reliable results measuring pupil dilation and thermal readings of erogenous zones.
Oh, good lord.
Wait, this is dextro cheese, right? Keela, did I forget to scan the cheese? This is why I don't drink.
Fair's fair, trainer. Edie has a right to ask about what you said.
Oh, we are going to talk later.
I was very interested in trainer's ability to develop sexual feelings for what was, at the time, a bodiless voice.
You are all terrible. Edie, I apologize for saying that I wanted to roll naked with your voice in satin sheets.
Oh, I was not offended. In fact, it was flattering.
Even the part where I wanted to grab your voice by the hair and nibble my way down its back.
Let's remember that one for later, actually.
I do not, in fact, remember you saying that, Samantha.
Oh, that wasn't out loud. Never mind.
Don't mind me. I'm just going to run a toxin treatment program so I don't die.
Well, that was mortifying.
Tell me about it. Hey.
Worst planet to get shot down over? We're talking pre-war?
Pre-war, life-bearing worlds only.
I'm going with Tarith. Garden world, yes, but it's got those chlorine swamps.
I will see your Tarith and raise you Azoria, home of toxic spores and athlete's lung.
Neither of you'd last a day on Tuchanka. And Tuchanka supports life.
I think you meant to say consumers.
That's the point. It's got critters that'll rip your guts out.
Hey, guys. Talking shop?
No worries. This is fun for us. So, you don't have a sidearm under your pilot's chair?
The weapons locker is on the bridge, practically right there.
A weapon you can't get to is no weapon at all. When's the last time you trained with a handgun?
Sometime before I got the ass-kicking robot as my co-pilot.
That's no good. What if you have to save Edie someday?
Unacceptable. You should always train. Pilots are warriors, too.
You know what this is? It's a man emergency. Take this kid out back and make him do target practice.
Exactly. Some range time will fix you up. Right, Commander?
You are not taking me shooting. My testosterone levels are plenty high. I fly a deadly war machine, remember?
I'm going to regret this later.
Joker's body count is plenty high. You don't need to take him anywhere.
This is not about me knocking Joker. This is about being prepared for the worst.
Man, I didn't hear of any gunplay when Rex grabbed your shuttle on Sirkesh.
If there had been, I'd have killed our best shot at an alliance with the Krogan.
You mean you would have wounded it? Ha!
And maybe we should drink. To brains as well as guns.
Done. Great party. I'd better see you out on the dance floor later.
We'll see.
Your guests appear to be enjoying themselves, Commander. What shall I do now?
Let's turn up the music and get some people dancing.
Very good, Commander. I have had little opportunity to use my bounce and spin functionality.
Jeff.
Yes, Edie.
At social events like this, it is customary to dance with friends or loved ones. Would you dance with me?
It's gonna take a lot more than a polite request to make that happen, Edie.
I have recordings of you talking in your sleep that would make for a highly amusing extranet video.
Okay, that's cheating.
So he won't dance with you, huh?
Hello, Shepard. He will not.
Well, I will.
Seriously, though, don't go there.
Well, then maybe you should dance with her.
Other people are dancing, Jeff.
Yes, they are. And I am sitting here enjoying my drink.
Joker!
No.
Come on!
No!
Seriously?
Ugh! Fine.
You should bring out those moves more often, trainer.
You and I dancing at the same time? Too dangerous. We'd light the room on fire.
I'm always amazed humans can dance with the way your legs bend.
The way our legs bend.
Yes, you and the Asari. I'm surprised you don't tip over.
We do what we can. Captain on deck!
Has she always been like this?
Shepard is saving the galaxy. You have to forgive a few eccentricities.
I love and treasure you, darling. But that is terrible.
We should record this and broadcast it for the Reapers. They'll either run away, melt down, or fall in love.
Well, I like it, Commander. It's good to see you cut loose now and then.
Thank you for all your loyalty and support.
Could not.
Could you? I could float you off this balcony without breaking a sweat.
Oh, I know you could, but do you have the cojones to actually do it?
James.
Shepard.
What's up?
Just proving a point. I think James has a newfound respect for biotics.
You okay, James?
Yeah, this is trippy. I'm I'm kind of buzzing all over.
Do you find it relaxing?
Kinda. Among other things.
I'm glad you lost that bet, James. When's my turn?
Careful. I need my full crew back when the night's over.
Okay, you've had your fun. Put me down now.
Come on, let's dance.
Just the way.
Lovely.
Really? You have them all memorized?
Dancing during wartime wastes precious energy. Krogan dances usually involve more headbutts and blood and no actual dancing. Shepard!
So here's where the party's at.
Now it is. Good to see you, Shepard.
Easier to talk back here. What do you think of the music? Great? Bad? What? Not as good as in your cycle, eh, Javik? Am I right?
Not even remotely.
Knew it.
Oh, maybe we can leg wrestle later. Perfect end to a perfect evening.
Sure. Absolutely.
I'll look for you later then, maybe. I got a piss.
Dancing is often considered pleasurable, Jack.
Well...
Hello, Commander.
Are you having fun?
Kind of.
Excellent.
Hey, Edie, check this out.
Oh, pancreas.
Hey, everyone. Come over here for a minute. Let's get a photo to remember this. Arrange yourselves on the sofa.
An excellent suggestion, Shepard.
Great idea. I want a copy.
Make way. Make way.
Thanks for coming, everyone. Here's to us. Ready, Glyph?
Of course. If you could all please direct your attention this way.
Okay. Everyone say Normandy.
Normandy!
Definitions of hair. What did we do last night?
What didn't we do last night?
I want to treasure this moment before I start remembering all the drunken antics I need to apologize for.
Was someone making tea? I could use some tea.
Did we, break anything last night? I don't suppose you need anything around here calibrated. Yeah, okay, maybe I should just stop saying that word, but only if Liara stops saying, "By the goddess."
Some neighbors came by last night to complain about the noise. I put their bodies in the building incinerator.
Morning, Shepard. Hope you slept well.
Shepard? Morning. I need a floor to curl up on.
Okay, who wants eggs? Liara, eggs? Trainer. Esteban, eggs? Joker.
I think I broke my head on something last night.
Hey, Commander. Hell of a night.
Been a while since I hit the hard stuff. About time.
Duty calls, huh? Even with a hangover?
There's still a war on.
Unless the Reapers are on shore leave, too?
I'm guessing they're not. Round everyone up, pass out the aspirin, and have them report to the Normandy.
You got it.
So much for shore leave.
At least we threw one hell of a party. Probably the last one.
Come on, none of that. I know you. You always find a way to save the day, no matter what. This wasn't what I signed up for, but it's been a good ride.
Best.
You should go see Adams, Commander.
Commander, we've installed that thermal pipe you got us. It was quite successful. The Normandy will explode long before the core needs to vent into the engineering compartment.
So that's good news.
Can't be. No. I guess that's right.
Hey, Tally. How's it going?
Oh, sorry. I didn't hear you. I just got communication from the fleet. Sorry, from Rannoch. In the old days, I'd send any new technology I found back to the fleet. I should probably be doing that with the agriculture samples now. I don't know anything about raising crops.
How are your people doing?
Planetary defenses are under Quarian control, and we're establishing facilities for food production.
Geth tech is still similar enough to ours that we've got a ton of raw material for repairs. We'll be up and fighting soon.
I wish your people could take the time to rebuild properly. But you know I need the fleet.
No, we've spent centuries running. The Quarians are ready to fight. We've already got carriers bolstering the Turian fleet and evacuating refugees from colonies. When your Fifth Fleet launches the assault to retake Earth, we'll be there to blow the Reapers to hell.
Yakshi?
No.
I think that story would be perfect for you. The hidden dark side of the most beautiful race in the galaxy.
We have a huge Asari audience. If I do that story, I could lose them.
That seems a bit like pandering.
Ever seen how fast an e-democracy can abandon its allies?
No.
If I do my job, you won't. Commander, I'm doing a segment on the Geth-Quarian War. It should take maybe an hour. Can we talk in your cabin?
Hey there. Hey there.
Have we heard from Agent Detrace yet?
She has not reported in for over 8 hours, Doctor.
She was stationed on Valcheer when the Reapers invaded. I think we can assume what happened. Inform Agent Calamus he's now in charge of reporting Reaper activity past the Loas relay. Hello again, Shepard.
How much do you know about this Prothean artifact?
Very little. We're fortunate enough data survived to piece together the blueprints. Decoding them will require as many specialists as we can find.
It's that high-tech?
I'd have killed for a glimpse of it during graduate school.
So is that drone your new secretary?
Glyph is a VI shell that indexes my search functions on the data feeds. I couldn't work without it. Although, I'm lucky Edie let Glyph on board after it tried to rewrite her scheduled tasks.
I was merely attempting to standardize the ship's automated systems to our own, Dr. Tassoni.
Yes, that's precisely why you're confined to the cabin.
What's been happening with you as the broker, Liara?
It's been exciting. The old broker's ship, impressive, but it was never meant to be spaceworthy. Which meant the elusive man eventually tracked me down on Hagalaz.
What happened?
I knew he was coming. Ferran and I loaded as much of the ship's specialized hardware onto a shuttle as we could. We got away from Cerberus' ships after arranging an appropriate distraction.
What kind of distraction?
Sending the broker's ship exploding into a Cerberus cruiser. I don't think the elusive man expected me to give up my resources in such a spectacular fashion.
Can you still operate as the broker without the ship?
Well, I couldn't let the elusive man have it. I saved what was crucial. My network of agents is intact, although the Reapers have taken a toll on their numbers. It's taking a while to re-establish contact.
So where is Ferran if you two escaped?
He convinced me he was recovered enough to work, and I do need more agents.
Agent Ferran didn't report any injuries during his last call to you, Doctor.
True. Given what he survived, I should probably worry less.
What have you been up to since we last saw each other?
Since you helped me defeat the Shadow Broker, I started looking for defenses against the Reapers.
The Protheans were the only ones with substantial information on them. The older civilizations barely had records. I knew the elusive man was hunting for the same thing when our agents began crossing paths.
Like on Mars.
I thought I'd covered my tracks, but he had surveillance there all along.
We'll talk later, Liara.
Of course.
Thank you for the data packet. The results are available on the Information Network Terminal.
Not right now. Not right now.
Commander.